Hello friends, my name is Tushar and today I'm going to talk about AVL tree. Before talking about AVL tree, let's talk about binary search tree. A binary search tree is a special kind of binary tree where everything on the left subtree is less than or equal to root and everything on the right subtree is greater than or equal to root, and this is recursively true for every node. AVL is a special kind of binary search tree where the difference of the height of the left subtree and the right subtree will never be greater than 1. Let's look at some example and see which ones are AVL tree and which ones are not. All these trees are binary search tree. Now let's see if they are AVL tree or not. So with every node, I have the height of the left subtree and right subtree written right there. So for 10, height of the left subtree is 2 and right subtree is 1 and the difference is 1. So 10 does not violate the property of AVL tree. For 2, height of the left subtree is 0, right subtree is 1, so 2 also does not violate. 8 does not violate and 15 does not violate. So this is an AVL tree. What about this one? Again, for 10, height of the left subtree is 2, right height of the right subtree is 2. So 10 does not violate the property. 2 does not, 8 does not, 15 does not, and 18 does not. So this is also an AVL tree. Let's look at this tree. For 10, height of the left subtree is 3, height of the right subtree is 2. So 10 does not violate the property of AVL tree. What about 2? For 2, height of the left subtree is 0 because there is nothing on the left side, and height of the right subtree is 2. So the difference of left subtree and right subtree is greater than 1. So 2 violates the property of AVL tree. So this is not an AVL tree. Next, let's talk about why we need an AVL tree. Look at this tree here. This is a perfect binary search tree, but the problem is this has a runtime complexity of O of n. Searching into this tree, insertion into this tree, or deletion into this tree, all of them has O of n time. And the only reason we use binary search tree is so that we can improve on O of n time, because even linked lists and arrays can do all this in O of n time. And the reason we use binary search tree is to get a better performance than that, which is where the AVL tree comes into the picture. So the additional constraint that the height of the left subtree and right subtree, difference of the height of the left and right subtree cannot be greater than 1, leads to a much more balanced tree, which leads to a O of log n time for searching, inserting and deleting into an AVL tree. So again, time complexity of AVL tree is O of log n for searching, deleting and insertion. Next, let's look at how do we insert into an AVL tree. There are 4 simple rules to follow while doing an insertion into an AVL tree. Left, 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 right, right, and right, left. Let's understand what that means. So this is an AVL tree. Let's say I was trying to insert minus 20 into this AVL tree. So I go to 10, minus 20 is less than 10, so I come to 5. Minus 20 is less than 5, so I come to minus 10. Minus 20 is less than 10, minus 10, so I go here and put minus 20 right here. Now minus 20 does not violate the property of AVL tree, so we go to minus 10. Minus 10 does not violate the property of AVL tree, so we go to 5. 5 violates the property of an AVL tree. And the height of the left subtree from 5 is greater than the height of the right subtree, so it's a first left comes from that point. And for 5's left child, the height of the left subtree is greater than the height of right subtree, so second left comes from that point. If we have a left-left case, all we have to do is do a rotation at minus 10. So this becomes 10, minus 10, 15, 5, and minus 20. So this tree is a BST, and also it does not violate the property of an AVL tree. So this is an AVL tree. Next, let's look at left-right case. Instead of this tree, if we had something like this, and now let's say I'm trying to insert minus 5 into this tree. So minus 5 is less than 10, so it comes here. Minus 5 is less than 5, so it comes here. Minus 5 is greater than minus 10, so it inserts right here. Now going up, minus 5 does not violate the property of an AVL tree. Minus 10 does not violate the property of AVL tree. 5 does. So for 5, height of the left subtree is greater than the height of the right subtree. That's where the first left comes from. And for its left child, minus 10, height of the left subtree is less than the height of the right subtree, so that's where the right comes from. So then, first we do is do a rotation here in here, a left rotation in here, so this becomes 10, 5, minus 5, minus 10, and 15. So this becomes a left-left case first, and now we do a rotation at this point to convert it into an AVL tree. Next, let's look at right-right and right-left case, which are the mirrors of this examples. Next, let's look at the right-right and right-left case. So if I have an AVL tree right here, and now I'm going to try to insert 40 into this AVL tree. So 40 is greater than 10, so it comes here. 40 is greater than 20, so it comes here. 40 is greater than 30, so I insert 40 right here. Now, 40 does not violate the property of an AVL tree. 30 does not violate the property of an AVL tree. 20 does. So 20 is the first node which violates the property of an AVL tree. And for 20, height of the right subtree is greater than the height of the left subtree. That's where the first right comes from. And then for 20 is right, height of the right subtree is greater than height of the left subtree. So that's where the next right comes from. So if we have a right-right case, all we need to do is a rotation from this point here. So this becomes 10, 5, 30, 20, and 40. So this is a BST, and also it does not violate any of the AVL tree properties. Next, let's look at the right-left case. Suppose my AVL tree was 40 here, and now I'm trying to insert 30 into this AVL tree. So 30 is greater than 10, 30 is greater than 20, 30 is less than 40. So 30 becomes the left child of 40. So 30 does not violate the property of AVL tree, 40 does not violate the property of AVL tree, 20 does, because the height of the left subtree is 0, height of the right subtree is 2, and the difference is greater than 1. So then, for 20, height of the right subtree is greater than height of the left subtree, so that's where the first right comes from. And if we go to 20's right, 40, height of the left subtree is greater than height of the right subtree, so that's where the next left comes from. So this, we'll first do a right rotation here, so this becomes 10, 20, 30, 40, and 5. So this now becomes a right-right case. This is still not an AVL tree, so now we do a rotation from here to make it an AVL tree. So 10, 30, 40, and 5. So this is a BST, and it also is an AVL tree. Next, let's analyze the time complexity for this insertion. If you notice, the worst case, the number of rotations we'll do is the height of the binary of this AVL tree. So if we were inserting here, this might need two rotations, this might need two rotations, and this might need two rotations in the worst case. So still, that will be 2 of log n work, which will have O of log n complexity. So insertion into an AVL tree is O of log n. Since AVL tree is a balanced tree, a search into an AVL tree will also be of O of log n. Next, let's create an AVL tree given certain integers. Now I'm going to insert these elements into my AVL tree in this order, and we're going to use our understanding of left-left, left-right, right-right, and right-left to maintain the property of an AVL tree. Let's see. So I have 1, which is a root of my AVL tree. This is the height of the left subtree, and this is the height of the right subtree. Right now, both of them are 0. 2 comes along. Height of the left subtree for 2 and height of the right subtree is 0. And for 1, height of the right subtree is now 1. 3 comes along. Since 3 is greater than 1, it goes to 2. It's greater than 2, so it goes here. And height of the left and right subtree is 0, 0. For this one, height of the left tree is 0, but height of the right subtree is 1. And for this, height of the right subtree becomes 2. So now the difference of the height left, now the difference of the left and height right subtree is greater than 1. So this violates a property of an AVL tree. And this is a right-right case, so we need a rotation here. So this becomes 2, 1, 3, 1, 1 height of left and right subtree, 0, 0, and 0, 0. All right, let's insert 6. So 6 comes here. 0, 0. Height of the right subtree becomes 1. Height of the right subtree becomes 2. So none of them violate the property of an AVL tree. Notice how when a new element comes along, all only nodes whose height will be updated are the one through which it traversed to reach this point. Let's say now 5 comes along. So only nodes whose height will be updated are the nodes whose path we took to reach this point. So this becomes 0, 0. This becomes 1. This becomes 2. So this here violates the property of AVL tree, because height of the right subtree is greater than height of the left subtree by 2. So this is a right case, so we'll need a rotation here. So this becomes 2, 6, 3, 5, and 1. So height of the right subtree is 2, height of the left subtree is 1. This is 0, 0. This is 1, 1. This is 0, 0. And this is 0, 0. So this is an AVL tree now. Now minus 2 comes along. So height of the left subtree increases by 1. Height of the left subtree increases by 1. So this is still maintaining the property of an AVL tree. Then minus 5 comes along. This is 0, 0. This becomes 1, 0. This becomes 2, 0. So as soon as this becomes 2, 0, this is now violating the property of an AVL tree, because height of the left subtree is greater than the height of the right subtree by 2. And this is a left-left case, so we'll need a rotation from here. So this becomes 2, 6, 5, 3, then minus 2, 1. And minus 5. And height is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2. Now minus 8 comes along, so it goes here. 1, 0, 0. 1, 0, 2, 1, and 3, 2. And none of them violate the property of an AVL tree. Again, when I was inserting minus 8, minus 8 is less than 2, it's less than minus 2, it's less than minus 5, so it came here. Now when I insert minus 8, I need to update the heights of the entire path which 8 took to come to this point. So we updated this one, we updated this one, we updated this one, and at every point we keep checking if they are violating the property of an AVL tree or not. If they are violating the property of AVL tree, we will use one of our cases, left, 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 right, or right, left, to rotate them in one direction or the other direction. And as I said before, in the worst case, the total number of rotations it will happen is 2 into the height of this binary tree. So the insertion time for this for AVL tree is O of log n. Also, since it's a balanced binary search tree, the search time is also O of log n. Now finally, let's look at the code to insert into AVL trees. Now let's quickly look at the write rotate function and see how this works. Right now I have this tree, and this is an AVL tree. Suppose I was trying to insert minus 10 into this tree. So minus 10 is less than 20, so we come here, it's less than 15, it's less than 10, so minus 10 is here. This does not violate AVL property. This node does not, this node does not, but this node does. Here, height of the left subtree is 3, height of the right subtree is 1. So the difference is greater than 1. So this node is violating AVL tree property. So what we're going to do is we're going to rotate from here. So right rotate takes root. Root here is 20. Then new root is equal to root dot left. So new root is 15. Then I'm saying root dot left is equal to new root dot right. So 15's right becomes 20's left. Since everything on the left of 20 is less than 20, so 15's right can easily become 20's left. So 20, 18, 25. Then I'm saying new root dot right is equal to root. So here 15, right becomes 20, 10 minus 10. And then I'm setting the height of root and new root. So now that we have done some rotations, their height will change. So 20's new height will be 2, because height of the max of height of left and right sub 3 plus 1, so that's 2. And 15's new height will be max of left or right sub 3 height plus 1, so that's 3. And now this tree here is not violating AVL tree property, and it is an AVL tree. Similarly, we can have a left rotate, which is a mirror image code for the right rotate, so I'm not going to discuss that case. Finally, let's merge all this together and look at how the actual insertion works. Let's quickly look at how we actually insert into an AVL tree. Before we go there, I want to point out that at every node, I'm keeping an extra variable height, which is going to give the height of the subtree rooted at that node. So for example, at minus 10, the height is 1. At 5, the height is 2. At 10, the height is 3. At 20, the height is 1. So this is going to help me quickly get the height of the left and right subtree and see if the tree is balanced or not. Let's look at the code here. The name of the function is avlinsert. It takes a root of the AVL tree and the data I need to insert. This part here is a regular binary search tree insert. If the root is null, I create a new node and return. Otherwise, if data is less than equal to data, I recursively go on the left side and find the point at which I need to insert the data. Otherwise, I go on the right side and find the point at which I need to insert the data. This part here is keeping the AVL balance. First thing I do is find the balance, which is the difference of the height of the left subtree and right subtree. If this balance is greater than 1, it means that the height of the left subtree is greater than the height of the right subtree by more than 1. And if that happens, it needs a rotation. And we know that it leads to two cases, left-left case or left-right case. So let's work with an example here. If I was trying to insert minus 20, minus 20 comes right here. This minus 20 does not violate AVL property. Minus 10 does not, 5 does. So what we need is a rotation right here. Also, since we come here, balance is greater than 1, height of the root left, so height of here height's 20's height left subtree at minus 10 is greater than the height of the left subtree at minus 10 is greater than height of the left of right subtree at minus 10. So this is a left case. So what we do is one right rotation. So we just rotate it here at minus 10. So this becomes minus 10, 5, minus 20, and then we return minus 10 to the calling function, so 10's left becomes minus 10 now, and it itself checks if it follows the AVL property or not. So this becomes an AVL tree. Let's try insert minus 5 here. If we try to insert minus 5 here, it comes here. Again, this does not violate AVL property. 10 minus 10 does not, 5 does. So again, it is a left-right case. So here, what we are going to do is we first do a left rotation. So this becomes minus 5, minus 10. And then we do a right rotation here. So this becomes minus 5, 5, and minus 10. So those are the two cases described right here. If height of root left is greater than or equal to height of root left right, then we have a left case, else we have a left right case. In case of left right, we first do a left rotate from root left, and then we do a right rotate, and then we return the new root from there. If balance is less than minus 1, it means that the height of the right subtree is greater than height of the left subtree by more than 1. In that case, we again have right case and right left case. And those cases are mirror images of left-left case and left-right case. If none of this happens, then we just set the root's height, which will be the max, 1 plus max of the height of the left subtree and right subtree, and then we return root. This is all I have to say about AVL tree and inserting into an AVL tree. If you want the link to this code, go to the description of this video. You can also check out my GitHub link, github.com/missionpiece_interview_wiki. And you could check out my YouTube channel, youtube.com/user_tushar_right2525. Thanks for watching this video.